Did you ever ponder? When we pull the skin off our hand, it returns to its normal position. Why does this happen? It's because of elastin. What is the second most abundant connective tissue in the body? Elastin. Now let's study about this. There is no rocket science here. As evident from name, elastin is a rubber-like protein and it can be stretched up to 2 times its length without breaking. And it returns to its original size as well. Let's learn about it further. Location. So it is found in blood vessels, especially arteries, in lungs, especially in the walls of alveoli, and in skin. It is also present in elastic ligaments and elastic cartilage production and structure. So, nucleus have ELN gene which undergoes transcription and produces messenger RNA. It comes outside the nucleus where it is translated and an elastin precursor protein is produced which then goes to rough endoplasmic reticulum and here it is modified just like collagen. But this time there is less modification as compared to collagen. For instance, there is less glycosylation, less hydroxyproline formation, and there is no hydroxylysine formation. Now, a molecule is generated which we call tropoelastin. It comes out of cell. Now, it requires a scaffold. So, it uses fibrillin as scaffold, and by attaching on it, it forms a long chain. This chain have approximately 700 amino acids. And most of amino acids are small and nonpolar. For example, glycine, alanine, and valine. Also, it have abundant proline and lysine like collagen. Now, in the presence of lysyl oxidase, lysine at some points of chain undergoes oxidative deamination. So, an aldehyde group is produced. Now, aldehyde and amino group of two elastin chains come closer and form cross linkage between themselves. Now, a highly hydrophobic compound is produced, which is called desmosine. And it happens to a lot of elastin chains. And we get a network, something just like this. Importance. Just as you know, collagen is strong but not elastic. Where, on the other hand, elastin is also elastic. So whenever there is shortage of elastin, our skin loses its elasticity and we get something in our face which we call wrinkles. So the reason behind wrinkles in face with advancing age may include elastin underproduction. And one more thing, once elastin is damaged, it cannot be repaired. Now let's talk about its degradation. Elastin is broken down by elastase. These are the enzymes which are released by neutrophils during infection or inflammation. And when elastin is destroyed, tissue also gets destroyed. To prevent this, our body has alpha-1 antitrypsin, which can destroy this elastase as well. It is called alpha-1 antitrypsin so that it destroys the pancreatic enzyme trypsin. That is why it is antitrypsin. But nowadays its name is changed. It is now called alpha-1 antiproteinase because it breaks not only trypsin but also different proteolytic enzymes of our body. And among these different proteolytic enzymes, there is also an elastase. It means it breaks elastase, the elastin destroyer.